Hi dear students, how are you all? Are you all fine? Stay at your home, stay safe, and let's learn through Avopade. Today we are going to discuss the topic balancing equation. Okay, it's not that much complex. I'll make it very easy for you all. Okay, so first we are going with the example formation of water. Formation of water, as you all know, hydrogen plus oxygen gives water H2O. Right, so we all know that a balance, that we use it in the provisional store in the vegetables, like with the vegetable cellar and all. What we try to make is both the sides equal, and then we'll come to know that both the sides masses are equal. Here also same thing, LHS, RHS should be right hand side and left hand side should be equal, and like the reactant side and the product side should be equal. That is what we have to do. Very simple thing. Okay, the formula that we know, no changes in the formula, just we have to make the changes in the coefficient, and we have to equalize the both the sides. Okay, in the reactant side we have two hydrogen, and in the product side also we have two hydrogen. But in the case of oxygen, in the reactant side we have two oxygen, but in the case of product side we have only one oxygen. So first we have to equalize or like balance the number of oxygen in both the sides. How can we do? Can we make it H2O2 by making the oxygen number 2? No, we cannot do that, because then that will become hydrogen peroxide. So we cannot do that. We can just make the changes in the coefficient of the like compound. Okay, whatever be the compound given, just in front of that we write the number of molecules, that only we can change. Okay, so here first what we are going to do is the number of water became 2. The number of oxygen here is 2, and here also we have to make it 2. So we cannot make the formula change. So what we have to do is we can make the coefficient 2 over here. So it will be 2H2O, right? So here the oxygen number is 2, and here also 2 into 1, the oxygen number is 2. But the next thing is the number of hydrogen in the product side is 4 now. How? 2 molecule of water means 2 hydrogen into 2, that will become 4. So what we have to do now, we have to make the number of molecules of hydrogen also 2. So what will happen? 2 into 2, that will make 4. Here we have 4 hydrogen. Now you check, you can find that you can have both the sides equal number of atoms, like H2, that is 2 hydrogen into 2, so it will be 4 hydrogen, and here oxygen O2, 2 hydrogen, and here 2 molecules of water, 2 into 2, 4, and 2 into 1 oxygen, 2. So it's equalized, it's balanced. The next example that we are going to take is formation of sodium hydroxide, that is Na plus H2O gives NaOH and hydrogen. Just go through the equation, then you will come to know that the number of atoms in both the sides are not equal. Like sodium is equal Na1, Na1. But hydrogen H2 here and H3 here, that is 1 over here and 2 over here. So it will be 3. And oxygen 1 here, 1 here, equal. Okay, so now we have to make both the sides equal. What changes can we make here? That is what we have to go through first. So first, can we make the molecule of hydrogen into 2? So if we check that, you will come to know that then 2 into 2, 4, and here 1, then it will be 5. So we cannot make the changes in the number of water molecules into 5. That is a bit difficult. So what else can we do? What we can do is we have to make the changes in the sodium hydroxide. So we cannot make changes in the formula. So what we have to do, we can make the changes, the coefficient into 2. So it will be 2 sodium, 2 oxygen, and 2 hydrogen. Okay, so hydrogen 2 here from this side, and here also we have 2 hydrogen. So it becomes 4. Now we'll go to the reactant side. Okay, here we have 1 water molecule. So we'll make it into 2. So what will happen? 2 into 2, 4 hydrogen and 2 oxygen. So here number of hydrogen and oxygen become, and here when we have 2 NaOH, we have 2 over here. So we have to make 2 over here for making the coefficient 2. So Now the equation is equalized, very simple. Okay, first you just go through the equation, then you will get an idea that how you have to increase the number of atoms. Anyway, we cannot make changes in the formula of any of the compounds given. So just you have to do is the formula that we know, no changes in the formula, just we have to make the changes in the coefficient and we have to equalize the both the sides. Okay. And now I think that this topic is clear for you all. So try to find out more examples and try to do more. Like when you do more these kind of examples, it will be more easy and clear for you all. Okay, try to do it and all the best.